the lock. I'll have to find you.
Okay, officer. So here's the dough.
I hope it won't happen again.
So, you killed Morello. That must have felt good, huh?
We celebrated. Salieri was thrilled, of course. We ran the whole town, practically, and there seemed to be an end to the bloodshed. For a while, I felt like a king, until I came to a realization. If a regular guy like me could kill the most powerful man in the city, what good was all his power? Hell, if he hadn't been so powerful, he'd probably still be alive. It seemed to me that no matter how strong someone was, there was always somebody stronger to take them out.
So where did that intuitive thought take you?
Greediness is bullshit. When you have no money, you think that a few bucks a month will be enough. Then you realize that it wouldn't be bad to have a nice car. You'd get a great job in some high-up position, but in actuality, you're thinking about going higher. Before you know it, you want to be the President of the United States, and you want to win the war against the Germans. Luckily, that won't happen. Plus, the whole strategy of watching other people's backs has one basic flaw. The whole time you have to watch your own back, in case someone else has the same idea. So I thought to myself that maybe I ought to change my priorities a little.
Great Bible story.
Laugh it up. You know where it got me in the end. This.
Who is it?
It's from 1920. The old man is Don Pepone. The two younger ones are Salieri and Morello. This photo convinced me that this kind of life is poisonous. Morello and Salieri were friends, and they were both commanders of Pepone's regime. But in the 1920s, they got Don Pepone killed because of some deal. Strangely enough, Salieri still admires the guy now. Afterward, they divided up the city, and each ruled their own part of it. But they started to compete with each other. I ended up being Salieri's instrument of death to kill his best friend, to save him from looking Morello in the eye. It occurred to me that my friends and the people I loved were the same. Someday I'd turn to Paulie and be looking straight down the barrel of a gun. I couldn't be sure of anybody, above or below me.
But you were risking your life every day. Being a sharpshooter for the Mafia ain't no bed of roses the way you tell it.
It's different when you're living it. When you're full of energy and you're fighting for your life with someone who's like your brother. You're just two soldiers who know what needs to be done. And it all depends on your ability to survive. It's a war. The constant feeling that you can't even trust your best friend is terrible. You are alone, and death can come from anywhere. I'd lie awake at night wondering if the joke my best friend told me was really just a joke, or if I should get prepared for my own execution. A person needs someone he can trust.